Hello, dear students. Today we are going to talk about Velutha, who is a very dominant character in the novel The God of Small Things, written by Arundhati Roy. Velutha's character becomes significantly important because he is the one who is a Paravan belonging to a low caste, and he is the one who attempts to break the boundaries established by the Indian society with respect to its caste system. Roy has taken special care in order to make a dominant narrative with respect to this character. So that is why it's essential that the characters should be discussed in detail. For this purpose, I have chosen certain passages from the paragraphs of the novel, from the pages of the novel. These pages are 35, 36 and 37. In these pages, some of the history of the development of Velutha has been talked about, which is very much necessary to understand the character of Velutha as it has been devised by Roy in her novel, The God of Small Things. In that novel, Velutha's character has been dealt in detail, and that's what we are going to start with in this short video. Just a few details of the history which has taken part in the development of Velutha will be discussed. Well, I have selected one passage on page 35 for this purpose. In this passage, we get double type of information. One is that where we can see that Velutha is coming and going into the Eminem house, where not only Papachi and Mamachi were present, but also some of their offsprings like baby Kuchama and Estha and Rahil and Ammu are also present. But the writer takes us back at the time when Mamachi was a young girl. At that time also, the father of Velutha, Velia Papin, he used to bring Velutha with him, and since that time, Velutha is known very well inside the house of these people. And this Velutha was quite popular right now among many people. At that time, when Velutha's father, Velia Papin, used to bring him to the house of many people, at that time, there was a big difference between the high caste people and the low caste people, because the society was very much divided among differences of the caste system. And so, at that time, there were different kind of situations which were realized to the people that they were Paravan, they were untouchables, and therefore they should not come into the houses from the front door, they should come from the back door, and then they should go back, not by turning their backs on the people, but rather they should go back by keeping their faces towards them, and in the same way, wearing no shoes at all. And similarly, number of other things, that they cannot touch their parts, they cannot eat with them, such kind of severe differences or the boundaries used to exist at that time when Velutha was a child. And he has been therefore developing in such an environment, definitely has got the kind of knack in him that he is a Paravan and possibly he doesn't deserve these kind of things as these are. And perhaps Roy has also taken such a character in her novel in order to show what happens when one is already bracketed, when already one is thinking that he's got these rights and somebody is not going to give him these rights. With such a situation, when somebody develops up, what happens with that character? Well, on the same page 35, we do have one more passage which is really about the past of Velutha. For example, we are told that when Velutha was just 14 years of age, at that time he used to learn certain skills and arts with the people around him, and one of the kind people was John Klein. He was a German and he had landed in India in order to teach such arts to the people who are normally unable to go to school and unable to get these skills. He used to teach Velutha the art of woodwork, like making tables and chairs out of the wood, and making other small objects as well with the wood. And he would teach him very well. And Velutha was a very good student, and he would definitely learn these arts in a very good way. And that is why he became a very skillful type of person, that he could make tables, chairs, and other wooden objects as well. When Rahil and Esther met him doing so, they also found him very much dexterous, and they were very happy to see that wood was moving in his hand, just like a kind of flexible thing, and that is why Velutha was able to make anything. He had also done his school education, and that is why he doesn't seem to be a normal Paravan, where there was no education and no skill at all. Instead, Velutha was a very skillful person, and he could perform all such activities which were necessary for any young man at that time. But still, the traditional Paravanship or the untouchableness that existed there, and that was the part and parcel of Velutha's life that was going on. With these things, Velutha grows up, and with the passage of time becomes even more important in the life of Eminem people and in the life of that Kerala people as well. But still, he was dominated by the view that he was a Paravan and he was an untouchable person. Well, if you move beyond page 35 and shift on to page 36, and there is a again very fascinating paragraph which goes to show the terrible feeling of Velutha's father Valiappan, because he was a past generation person, and he realized the problem which can happen if some Paravan or untouchable tries to cross the boundaries of his life, which is depending mostly upon the people around him. And so he is very much upset with the feeling, is seeing that Velutha is learning skills and getting education and is interacting with the people of Eminem house and is making his place in the world, and that makes him terrified. He thinks that when the people of high caste will come to know that these things are happening with Velutha, they would definitely try to punish him, and they will, in a way, they can kill him as well. And that is why he was very much terrified. He tries to rectify the situation and tries to, stop him from doing so. He warns him as well. But Velutha is a person who does not take these things very seriously. In the same way, he ignored the advice of his father. But the father was very much terrified and tried to tell Velutha also in one way or the other. He tried to stop Velutha from learning more and from becoming important in the society. He also tried to show Velutha that if he continues to do so, one day can come when he can lose his life, or at least his father will be in danger. But Velutha does not care for that. He thinks that the life which he is getting, that life is different from the life of his father, and the responses which come to him, these are also different from his father. So therefore, he continues with his activities and rather becomes in a way a type of angry with his father by thinking that his father was jealous of him because of his skills, and the father was also not taking him positively in that way. He sometimes thinks of going out of his home, and definitely does go out of his home. He does not come back home for a number of nights. Instead, he continues to go there on the riverside, and there he would catch the fish as well. He would fry there the fish, and he would eat that as well, and sometimes slept there as well. In that way, in the darkness of the night, he would spend much of his time instead of coming back to home. Well, if we still proceed further on the next passages and try to have a look at the passage which begins with Velutha, Valiappan, and Kuttappan lived a little laterite hut, and where it ends at the in the whole world. If you look at this passage, that passage also goes through a lot of light on the developments which are taking place in the life of Velutha. Like his stay at the time of night near the river, that became very much important, because Amu too tried to visit that place during the nights, and so a kind of interaction was developing, and Velutha was breaking the boundaries which were feared to be broken by the father of Velutha, and he had warned him as well, but encouragement on the part of Amu was making the boundaries broken. And so if somebody breaks the boundaries established by the society for a very long time, there could be troubles for Velutha as well. Now, before interacting with Amu, Velutha was able to secure a very loving and very beautiful Nichi with the children of Ammon, like Rahil and Esther, because these two people started to visit the hut of Velutha, where he used to work as well, where he used to do a number of things as well. There, these two kids go and watch him for many hours, learning different arts from him, learning different stories from him, and he had become, therefore, a favorite of these people. In that way, the company was growing with the passage of time, and liking of each other was growing with the passage of time. Rahil and Esther could never realize that what's the difference between being a Paravan and being a non-Paravan. They couldn't realize that. And perhaps Velutha also did not realize that he was talking with the people who were from the high caste. These things continued to develop, and he became a favorite of this family, not only of the children, but also that of the mother. But we know very well that age-old established boundaries and the limits and the borders cannot break very easily, especially those borders which are constructed by the society as it has been constructed as per the caste system of the Hindu society. That boundary, that border, that limitation is not easy to break, and if someone dares breaking that, there is some kind of trouble waiting for him. And the same thing definitely would happen with Velutha. But so far in these passages and this short video, what we come across is that here Velutha's development is coming across. I mean, the history, how Velutha was brought up, how he learned different kind of arts, and how he became a different Paravan. Though he was very much resembling with the Paravan of India, but he was having a different psychology. In a way, he goes to represent the god of small things in this novel, because he's the one who breaks the boundaries. He's the one who makes small things, and he makes them very lovely. And everybody, therefore, when looks at that, thinks that he's the one who's made them. So he becomes the god of small things as well. And he's the one who suffers most because of breaking up the boundaries, because of bringing up the change in the society. So he's the symbol of change as well. He's the symbol of this dissolution of different kind of unnecessary bondages in the society, and that is why we can very safely call him the god of small things. However, in some next video, we will be able to find when he has broken the boundaries, what is the result of that. So far, this video was about the history and development of Velutha, and here we stop. Thank you for watching, everybody.